In this video, I will prove that this language is not regular. The task is to prove that the following language is not regular, which is that one. I shall use the closure properties, and it has already been shown that this language is not regular, which I have shown in another video. So, first I have a look at what this language exactly is. And it means we have a word or a string which consists of arbitrary long combinations of A's and B's, and the amount of A's and B's have to be the same. So that means in this language we have epsilon, we have AB and BA, we have something like AABB, and we have ABAB, or we have, no, we don't have a D. We have BBAA, and so on and so on. So all words in which we have the same amount of A's and B's. Now I will prove, like I did before, I will prove by contradiction that this language is not regular. That means I make the assumption that L1 is regular. That's my assumption. And if this leads to a contradiction down below, then I know that this assumption must be false. So my assumption in if L1 is regular, that means if I form the intersection between L1 and another language from which I know that is regular, then the result, which I can name like L1 bar. So if I form the intersection of two regular languages, then the result must also be regular. So that means L1 is also regular. And my L2, which I will choose for this proof, my L2 will be this one, which is a to the power of n, b to the power of m, so they are not related. And the number of n's will be equal or greater than 0, and the amount of m will be greater or equal than 0. So that means if I write the regular expression for this language, this is basically A star B star. It's just written more complicated because, well, I'm not actually allowed to use regular expressions here. But you know that this language is regular because I have a regular expression for it. So now I form the intersection. Now I form my L1 bar. And my L1 bar will look something like this. So, if you look at this language, at my L1, and now I want to form the intersection with this language, which has first all the A's and then followed by all the B's. That means I have all the A's first and the B's last. So if I form the intersection, then I will take out all the words. I will drop all the words that are not in that order. So this one falls out and these two fall out. And so as you can see now, if I have a language where the amount of A's and B's are the same, and all A's comes first and after that all B's, that means I have basically the language A to the power of N, B to the power of N, with, in this case, N greater or equal than 0. And here we already have our contradiction, because we know that this language here is not regular because I have already shown in a previous video, or in this case I just assume that it has been shown, I know that this one is not regular. But I said, if I form those intersections, then this one must be regular. So I have a contradiction. And that means because L1 bar is not regular, that means, and I know L2 is regular, that means L1 cannot be regular. So that means I have shown that L1 is not regular, because otherwise I wouldn't have gotten those contradiction after forming the intersection with a regular language.